Hello students, welcome in our YouTube channel. In last video, we have already discussed about sp hybridization and the formation of molecules. Today, in this video, we are going to learn about a new concept, which is a molecular orbital theory. Initially, we know all about valence bond theory. This valence bond theory provides a new concepts like theory, introduces some new important concepts like covalent bonds, then delocalization of electron around the nuclei, a new term like resonance, a shielding effect, etc., etc. A valence bond theory explains the formation of covalent bond very well. But this valence bond theory fails to explain a formation of covalent bond. A valence bond theory fails to explain or does not give a satisfactory explanation about a coordinate covalent bond. Then, according to valence bond theory, oxygen is a diamagnetic molecule. A magnetic in nature. But experimentally, it is observed that the oxygen molecule is not diamagnetic, but this oxygen molecule is a paramagnetic in nature. And valence bond theory does not give any satisfactory explanation about this paramagnetic nature of oxygen. During formation of oxygen, two oxygen atoms share a pair of electrons and form O2 molecule, which is diamagnetic according to valence bond theory. But in several experiments, it is observed that oxygen is a paramagnetic nature. Then this valence bond theory also fails to explain shapes as well as a stability of an electron deficient molecules like B2H6. How these molecules are formed, it fails to explain its shape as well as a stability. A valence bond theory explains a few concepts very well, but these are the major limitations or drawbacks of a valence bond theory. And hence, to overcome these drawbacks, a new concept, a new theory was proposed called as a molecular orbital theory, represented by MOTL. M stands for molecular, O means orbital, and T means theory. MOT means a molecular orbital theory. This molecular orbital theory gives a satisfactory or well explanation about the electron distribution in molecules. Instead of orbitals, this molecular orbital theory gives an explanation regarding the distribution of electrons in a molecule. Okay? This molecular orbital theory is necessary because hydrogen having atomic number 1. Its electronic configuration will be like that, 1s1. When this hydrogen atom having 1s1, that is one electron, combines with another hydrogen atom having one electron with anti-parallel spin, it will form a hydrogen molecules. A covalent bond is formed by the overlapping of atomic orbital. Suppose this is the overlapping of this 2s orbital. Here a sharing and pairing of electron pairs takes place, and a formation of a hydrogen molecule takes place. We can write the electronic configuration of an element or electronic configuration of atoms like that, 1s1 or 1s2, 2s2, etc., etc. Here the electronic configuration of hydrogen is 1s1. But after the formation of molecules, we cannot write the electronic configuration of this molecule according to a valence bond theory. But this molecular orbital theory provides a electronic configuration for the molecule also. That is, with the help of MO2, we can write the electronic configuration for the molecule. Okay? When these two hydrogen atoms have an electronic configuration 1s1, combines with another hydrogen atoms having same electronic configuration 1s1. Then the formation of a molecule takes place. These molecules contain two molecular orbitals. That is, this is a molecular orbital of hydrogen molecule and molecular orbital of hydrogen atom. This is a bonding molecular orbital and it is anti-bonding molecular orbital. These two electrons which are combined during overlapping of orbitals are present in this bonding molecular orbital, and hence we can write the electronic configuration of hydrogen molecule like σ1s2 and σ*1s0. Okay, 1s1, 1s1, electronic configuration of combining atoms, while σ1s2, σ*1s0 is the electronic configuration of hydrogen molecule. That is, with the help of molecular orbital theory, we can write the electronic configuration of a molecule also. This molecular orbital theory involves a formation of a molecular orbitals. Initially, we know that every atom contains the atomic orbitals. Atomic orbitals like s orbital, then p orbital, d orbital, f orbital, etc., etc. That is, the atomic orbitals are s, p, d, and f. While in molecules, our molecular orbitals are a sigma and pi molecular orbital. A sigma molecular orbital and pi molecular orbital. While the atomic orbitals are s, p, d, and f. Because this is the main difference. Molecular orbitals are sigma and pi. With the molecular orbital theory, we can write electronic configuration of molecules. Okay, these two new things are introduced by this molecular orbital theory. Formation of molecular orbitals. Formation of molecular orbitals. This molecular orbital, that is MO, are formed by the combination of atomic orbitals. That is, they are formed by the combination of atomic orbitals. The atomic orbitals have a specific wave property. See, psi. Atomic orbital having a specific wave function which is denoted by a psi. While these molecular orbitals have a square of wave functions. They have a square of wave functions which decides the probability of a finding of electrons in a molecular space. These molecular orbital have a square of a wave function which gives us a probability of a finding of electrons in a space of a molecule is called as a molecular orbitals. As we know that the combination of atomic orbital gives a formation of a molecular orbitals. These atomic orbitals combine together to form two kinds of a molecular orbital. That is, when their wave functions are added, then one kind of molecular orbitals are formed. When wave functions are subtracted, they will form another kind of molecular orbital. A first type is called as a bonding molecular orbital, while another type is called as an anti-bonding molecular orbital. That is, atomic orbital combined together in two different ways. That is, by the addition of their wave properties or by the subtraction of their wave properties. Formation of a bonding molecular orbitals. Bonding molecular orbital, in short BMO, a bonding molecular orbital. These bonding molecular orbitals are formed by the addition of wave functions or wave properties of atomic orbital. Suppose this is a first wave psi 1, another wave. When these two atomic orbitals combine together,
by the addition of their wave properties. Okay, during this addition, suppose this is the height of wave, this is height of another wave. After addition, after combination, the height of waves goes on increasing. A such kind of addition gives the formation of a molecular orbital. And this kind of addition of properties are known as a constructive interference. Constructive interference. That is, a bonding molecular orbitals are formed due to a constructive interference, that is, addition of wave properties. These bonding molecular orbitals are stable in nature. They have maximum stability, and the energy of this bonding molecular orbital is lower. They have a lower energy than a parent atomic orbitals. Okay? The molecular orbital formed by the combination of atomic orbital in which addition of their wave function takes place, that is a constructive interference. These are the stable orbitals, molecular orbitals. They contain a lower energy. In this bonding molecular orbital, there is a greater electron cloud or electron density. A electron density is a maximum around a combining a nucleus in a bonding molecular orbital. These are the important information regarding with a bonding molecular orbitals.